Hi, I'm Dr. Robin, aka 00Pi. In this video, I'm going to explain how to calculate the fractional composition of weak acids at a given pH. This is a process that works for both monoprotic and polyprotic acids, but in this video, we're only going to look at monoprotic acids. Before we dive into calculations, though, I need to explain what fractional composition is. Let's go back to basics. If you remember, an acid can be defined in a number of different ways. A simple way to think of it is that an acid is a molecule that can deprotonate. In other words, one of its hydrogens can leave the molecule and go into solution. And remember, a hydrogen atom without its electron is just a proton. It also leaves the conjugate base, the anion that's formed when the proton dissociates. Now let's take a minute to review what happens not just on the level of a single molecule, but what happens when you have a bunch of acid molecules. You may remember that there are two basic classes of acids. For a strong acid, no matter how many acid molecules you put into solution, all of them will deprotonate. Whereas for a weak acid, when you put a bunch of acid molecules into solution, only some fraction of them will deprotonate. One question you could ask is, at a given point, what fraction of your weak acid is in the undissociated form, the HA, and what fraction has deprotonated to become the conjugate base, the A minus? This is the question that fractional composition answers. Let's talk about notation. We're going to represent the fractional composition of the species we care about like this. The alpha tells us that we're looking at fractional composition, and the subscript tells us what thing this fraction represents. I have an X here because we're talking about this in generic terms, but we will usually substitute the name of the actual thing we're calculating fractional composition for here. For example, if we had a monoprotic acid, we might want to look at the fraction of the total that exists in the HA form, which we'd write like this, and the fraction that exists in the A minus form, which we'd write like this. We know from our Gen Chem study of equilibrium that the amount of weak acid dissociates is related to a special equilibrium constant called the acid dissociation constant. And you'll see later on that this helps us relate the concentrations of HA and A minus for a monoprotic acid. In general chemistry, you probably calculated the equilibrium concentrations of A minus and HA using everyone's favorite tool, the ice table. So why would we need to do it any differently? Well, when you did ice tables, you were often trying to find the pH of the solution. But what if you had the same concentration of that weak acid at a different pH? In other words, what if you had other things in your solution that changed the balance between A minus and HA? The closest you may have come to doing something like this in Gen Chem is doing common ion problems using an ice table. But there are levels of complexity where this approach no longer works. So by now you're probably wondering, Dr. Robin, how do we do this if not with an ice table? And of course I'm going to show you, but first with a monoprotic acid in this video and then with a diprotic acid in the next. You could apply these mathematical principles to any sort of polyprotic acid, triprotic, tetraprotic, or whatever, and after watching this video and the next, I hope you can figure out how to do that. Again, the definition of fractional composition is what fraction of the total acid that the species you're looking at comprises. A monoprotic acid can either be in the A minus form or the HA form. So the total amount of acid, which we're going to write like this, will be the amount you have of A minus plus the amount you have of HA. Note that we're always going to be working in molarities in my class. For a monoprotic acid, we can calculate two different fractional compositions, one for HA and one for A minus. The fractional composition for HA, alpha sub HA, will be the concentration of HA divided by the total concentration of the acid. I'm going to substitute in the expression for total HA that we calculated in the previous slide. And then the fractional composition of A minus, alpha sub A minus, will be the concentration of A minus divided by the total amount of HA. So here's what we have so far. I want you to notice something, that if we add the fractional composition of HA to the fractional composition of A minus, we are adding two fractions, which can be combined, and the simplified total equals one. That will always be true of your fractional compositions, because your fractions of each of the things you have, in this case, A minus and HA, have to add up to the whole amount that you started with. But this doesn't help us with our problem, which is that we want to know how the fractional composition is dependent upon pH. Well, we do have an equation that relates the concentration of HA, the concentration of A minus, and the H plus concentration. That's the equation for the acid dissociation constant, Ka. Let's take this equation and rearrange it so that we have HA on one side and everything else on the other. And now let's take the two equations we derived earlier and plug this expression in everywhere we see the concentration of HA. Well, right now this looks like a mess. So now we're going to multiply the top and the bottom of each of our fractions by Ka. When we do that, we get these expressions, which look marginally better since we no longer have fractions within fractions. What we're going to do to simplify it further is to factor out the A minus concentration in both the numerator and denominator of each fraction. And as you can see, in both of our fractional composition expressions, we can cancel out the concentration of A minus. So here's what we're left with. The first thing I want to notice is that whether we're talking about the acid or the conjugate base, the fractional composition of each component isn't based on the concentrations of A minus or HA at all. It's based on the Ka of the acid and the H plus concentration of the solution, which of course is related to the pH. And the second thing I want you to notice is that if we add up the fractional compositions of HA and A minus as we did before, using these expressions, and simplify it, it still equals 1. Now, when I walked you through that derivation and pulled out the Ka formula, it might have reminded you of a derivation you did with that same formula in Gen Chem, that of the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. That equation is typically used to calculate the pH of a buffer solution, a solution that contains both a weak acid and its conjugate base. But if you know the pH, you can calculate the ratio of the conjugate base concentration to that of its weak acid. So how is this fractional composition calculation any different? Well, in some ways it's not. In certain situations in lab, you could use the empirical data and only the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation to calculate the A minus and HA concentrations. But this equation is a little more flexible, and more importantly, it helps us explain some buffer behavior graphically. So let's look at some examples involving a weak acid. Tris hydroxymethyl aminomethane, which most lab people just call Tris. Tris is commonly used in biology labs as a buffer for growth media, among other things. Its pKa is listed as 8.07. Quick reminder that the pKa is the negative log of Ka, and so Ka would be 10 to the minus pKa. So the Ka of Tris would be 10 to the minus 8.07. Let's say we want to calculate the fractional composition of Tris and its conjugate base at two different pHs. 7.4, which mimics the pH of the human body, and 8.1, which is the current pH of seawater. We'll start with pH 7.4. At pH 7.4, the H plus concentration is 10 to the minus 7.4. So the fractional composition of Tris in its weak acid form is 10 to the minus 7.4 divided by 10 to the minus 7.4 plus 10 to the minus 8.07. That gives us a value of 0.82. You could do a similar calculation for the conjugate base form, or you could remember that the two values have to add up to 1, so alpha of A minus is 0.18. At pH 8.1, the H plus concentration is 10 to the minus 8.1. The fractional composition of the acid form of Tris would be 10 to the minus 8.1 divided by 10 to the minus 8.1 plus 10 to the minus 8.07, which gives us a value of 0.48. For the conjugate base form, you could either use the formula or subtract 0.48 from 1. Either tells us that the fractional composition of the base form is 0.52. You could see that by moving to a more basic pH, we end up with more of the base form and less of the acid form. But now I want to do what I promised earlier and show you a graph. I'm going to use Excel to make this. As you can see, I've got the value for Ka here in cell F4, and I put a range of pHs from 0 to 14 in column A. I'm going to use those pHs to calculate the H plus concentration in column B. Next, I'm going to put the formula for HA into column C. And the formula for A minus into column D. And then I'm going to cut and paste these all the way down. As always, it's good to double check the answer on at least one cell to make sure you didn't put in your formula wrong. So I'm going to scroll down to pH 7.4 and pH 8.1 to double check my answers. Now that I'm sure I got the formulas right, let's look at the graph. One thing this graph shows is something you may have learned about in Gen Chem, either while talking about weak acid strong base titrations or while talking about buffers. When your pH is equal to the pKa, your concentrations of acid and conjugate base are equal. Another thing this graph highlights is why we pick buffers in a certain range. In general, when you're making a buffer solution, you want to find a buffer whose pKa is within one pH point of the desired pH. You can see what happens if we get outside of that range. We either have very little acid form or very little base form. As a result, the solution no longer has much ability to absorb pH changes.
So the last thing we have to address is how do these fractional compositions relate to concentration? So it's pretty simple. The concentration of something is going to be its fractional composition times the total concentration of the acid. So for example, if we're talking about pH 7.4 and we had a 1 molar total solution, then the concentration of HA would be 1 molar, which is the total solution, times the 0.82 of the fractional composition. So we would have a 0.82 molar composition of HA. And then for A minus, again, it would be 0.18 times 1 molar. So 0.18 molar. And I just use 1 molar for ease of calculation. I mean, you could use anything. If it were 0.01 molar total, you'd have 0.082 molar HA and 0.018 molar A minus, for example.
In summary, the fractional composition formulas help us easily find relative concentrations of a weak acid and a conjugate base at a given pH without ice tables. Notice I say relative concentration. We're talking more about the relationship between the two concentrations than outright concentrations. Among other things, this information helps us understand buffer systems. The material we've covered in this video also forms an important foundation for what we're going to cover next, the fractional composition of diprotic acids. I'll drop a link to that video in the card on the screen, as well as in the description below. I hope this was helpful, and I look forward to seeing you again soon.